He just hit a grand slam and has two of the Saints' seven sacks in the game. Breeze throws Thomas with a catch to the 20. One timeout for the Saints. Obviously, the stop of the two-minute warning as Jalen Smith makes the tackle.
Yeah, 2 minutes and 20 seconds for Drew Breeze is a lifetime.
It's a turnover play, so it gets looked at. The call is interception on the field, and Mike Pereira, I certainly haven't seen anything that would change that call to view.
I haven't either. The ball does touch the ground, but he had control first, so I'm sure that at this point of the game that they will review it, which it now does look like they are going to do. And but to me, I think it will probably stay as an interception.
And the first for Jordan Lewis.
Sean Payton cannot believe that this has been a rough game for them all the way around. The good news right now for the Saints, if there is any, is the fact that there's 2:08 left. They still have a timeout, and they still have the two-minute warning. And so there's a chance that if they can come up with a stop, they could get the ball back.
The Saints defense had six sacks a week ago against Atlanta, seven in this one, and they're going to have to do some kind of work to get the ball back to Breeze. They have held, the Cowboys have, the Saints to 10 points in this ballgame. Who saw that coming? But this is the number three scoring defense in the league coming in. And to me, if the Dallas Cowboys win this game, they won it with their defense.
Well, they've won all games pretty much this year with their defense. Jacksonville, the offense, scored 40. But if this defense had not been as good as they've been this year, this game really would not have even had much importance. They kept this team in a lot of games and allowed them to win when an offense was struggling. But now,
after during the play, the ruling on the field stands. Interception.
This offense has continued to get better, and we talked about it. Regardless of whatever happens, this defense has played great. They had heard all week long about the Saints. Nobody was talking about how good they were and what the Saints were having to deal with. And we heard the report earlier, the talk that Jason Garrett gave to the team last night. Well, how much of an impact does that have? I don't know, but this defense has come out and played its best game of the year.
That's only the third interception of the season thrown by Drew Brees. And a timeout taken by the Saints on this side of the two-minute warning on a two-yard carry by Ezekiel Elliott. Jordan Lewis, a third-round pick from Michigan. But they have just overwhelmed at times this, and it has been a scoring machine on offense for the Saints here tonight.
Well, here's why. The pressure that they've been able to get on Drew Brees in his face, I've said it throughout this game, if it's just coming off the edge and the interior is secure where he can step up, he manages that very well. But when it's in your face, no quarterback likes it. But for him at 6 foot, he has a much tougher time than being able to see where to go with the ball. The interception that he had last Thursday night on Thanksgiving against Atlanta was the same situation. He had pressure in his face, makes an errant throw, uncharacteristic of him, that gets intercepted. Now, it wasn't a factor in that ball game. They had a pretty sizable lead. But the throw that Jordan Lewis intercepted there, I don't even know if he saw what he was trying to do. The ball just had no chance of a completion.
Cowboys get a first down. This game's over. How about a touchdown? Instead, it's off the right hand of Cooper and a flag with the coverage by Lattimore.
you're with us.
Pass interference, number 23. Defense, foul occurring in the end zone. First to go at the 1 yard line.
Can I disappear for a little while?
Yeah, I mean, so obviously you see the same thing we do. That didn't look like pass
interference. He actually does grab the inside arm, and that's what the back judge would be looking at. And if we get a shot from the inside after we come back, maybe we'll see that inside grab.
Well, it'll be first and goal from the one. 1:58 left in Arlington.
Even though you won't try our kingdom's favorite lager, since you are my guest, I will try your meat.
Indeed, it's got an amazing mouthfeel.
Can I just get it over with?
No, no, really take in the layered aromas.
The layered?
You'll notice a tinge of sour cream.
It's got a fantastic after essence, don't you think?
No, no, first you have to admire its color.
You know, I can't do it. Bud Light, please. And show these two to the wine cellar.
Bud Light. For the many, not the few.
XL guys aren't built like everyone else. That's why DXL isn't built like any other clothing store. With sizes starting at XL. From Lacoste to Levi's, Brooks Brothers, and more. Built to fit. Built XL. DXL.
Geico makes it so easy to manage my policy. With an app that lets me pay my bill, add a vehicle, or even file a claim, it's not just easy. It's aerobics in a recliner easy.
Airplane! Move it! Shimmy! And set, set, swivel! Keep it going! Keep, hold! Keep out, eh? Epic!
It's not just easy, it's Geico easy.
Yes, this is Bob Barnett in Chicago.
I was there when Bob Barnett made the first commercial wireless phone call. We were both working on that first network that would eventually become Verizon's. That call opened the door to the billions of mobile calls that we've all made since. I'm proud that I was part of that first call, and I'm proud that I'm here now as we build America's first and only 5G ultra-wideband network that will transform how we all live once again.
First call that we've made on the cellular system.
Saints are out of timeouts. The game's on the other side of the two-minute warning. Here's another look at Mike Pereira. Do you agree with the call?
I do. You know, it's when you see one hand go up to try to catch the ball, you look down at the inside arm. He actually has a grab up with both hands, and I do think it's the correct call.
Well, with no timeouts, the Dallas Cowboys are just sealing this victory. That was a big first down because of the penalty. That was a second down throw, and Breeze figured to get the ball back if they don't end up with a touchdown.
You know, I think that you look at this, Joe, Sean Payton called the timeout in front of the two-minute warning. So the Cowboys, if he had run that down to the two-minute warning, more than likely they would have run the ball, you know, to force him to use his last timeout and all that. In their minds, they've got a free play to take a shot that the pass really wasn't going to affect anything because of the two-minute warning. You just wonder how much that factored into the decision then by Linehan and Jason Garrett to take the shot, because I don't know that they'd do that if they'd let it run down the two-minute warning.
Here's tonight's precision play of the game presented by Gillette. And I guess fittingly, it's this last effort by the Cowboys defense as Jordan Lewis gets his first pick. This Cowboys team are wrapping up their biggest win of the season. That nod to Cowboy offensive lines of years gone by, as they just shut down the league's premier scoring machine and upset the Saints. As the Dallas Cowboys get a home win, and they go to 7-5. This was some effort tonight by Jason Garrett's team and by Rob Marinelli's defense.
Sure was. Now they've won four in a row, and you look at who those teams were against, Joe. They've won on the road prime time against Philadelphia. They then had